are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good.
I just need to check my grandfather in for an appointment.
All right.
My name is Charlene. His name is Badruddin. We are from India. My grandfather doesn't speak English, so I'm here to translate from English to Hindi. He thinks that there's something inside his ear, a bug or something. So he just wants to feel better and just get this bug removed.
Parapia, you can follow me.
Nikal jao.
I'm Dr. Dan Carruthers. I'm an ear, nose, and throat physician. I practice in Atlanta, Georgia. I've been here for about 10 years, and I treat adult and pediatric otolaryngology.
Hey guys.
Hey.
I'm Dr. Carruthers. Let's take a look in your ear.
My skin crawls every time I see someone with a bug in their ear. Typically, it's a cockroach. A cockroach has spiny legs, and it'll kind of get stuck in the ear canal. That's pretty terrifying, actually.
Yeah, so he was saying that something was bothering his ear.
Oh, yes. This is a cockroach, I think. All right, sir, we'll get this out. We're gonna get the other room ready, okay?
I look in the ear, and way down in the ear canal, there's like this wing that's covering the entire body, almost like Batman's cape. It's very, very close to the eardrum. In order to remove that, we need to go to the other room that has a little 3-millimeter telescope that I could place into the ear canal to figure out, you know, what this thing is and get it out.
We'll get this nightmare over for you, okay? Just have a seat right here.
Yes.
Depending on the type of bug that gets in your ear, if it had sharp, pointy parts on its legs like a cockroach, it could actually poke through your eardrum. The bug, as it crawls in, has no way to turn around. And so it just wants to keep going forward. You just want to get it out of there as soon as possible.
So, Mr. Parpi, can you tell me again exactly what happened? Did this occur at nighttime when you were sleeping or
sleeping
what?
Sleeping in the morning.
He was taking a nap in the afternoon.
8 a.m.
Okay. So you were in bed?
Yes.
Okay.
Then otherwise I couldn't.
So he said that he was just scratching it and he felt it like inside.
Crawling
so,
around.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
I have onion.
He said he put onion juice and oil.
Onion juice?
Always when his ear hurts, he just put onion juice in there and it works.
Onion juice, I was immediately surprised at like, you know, what did he do? Just go make some, juice some onions, or did he have it for, you know, cooking purposes? I wasn't sure. But as I think it turned out, it was like an ancient Indian remedy for ear problems, as his granddaughter told me.
So you made a little brew that you put in your ear and then it stopped moving?
Okay.
It appears to be, it's not moving. So I think you took care of that part. Let's take a look. So if you wouldn't mind telling him that this part of the ear canal is pretty sensitive, and I'll do my best to not have it hurt at all, but these little creatures are a little sharp. He needs to stay as still as possible, okay?
Papa, wo tumhare ko tumhare kaan mein dalega, lekin ye thoda sahi hai.
Main sign kar lunga.
He said he'll bear it.
Okay.
Yeah.
He seems tough. So I'm gonna go in here with my little camera, and we're gonna take a look inside the ear canal. So there's like an antenna or a leg.
You can't. I can't. I mean, I couldn't look at it because it was really, I don't know, gross.
So I don't know if that's the back or a wing or something, but we'll go for the shell, I think. All right.
So I'm going to use these tiny alligator forceps to remove the bug. I'm using a very small telescope, so I'm able to also put instruments inside of his ear. And there's an instrument that we call an alligator, which we probably should find a better name for that, because every time I ask for an alligator, people kind of are like, what? So it looks like a very small grasping instrument, and it's delicate, and you're able to grab small things out of the ear.
All right.
Do y'all do this?
This looks like a wing right here. Here, can you,
Is that it?
No.
Oh, that's
unfortunately,
that it?
It's not agreeing to come out in one piece.
Yuck.
when you go in there and you grasp this bug, you're hoping to get the whole thing out at once, but you know, you grasp it and you just hear this like crackling, like it's like potato chips or something. You know, the little bug legs, and I get nothing. And I have to go back in for more pieces.
Do you want?
Is this a housefly? Or a bee?
It's a bee. I guess it's a bee.
What in the world?
What? Oh my God.
What is this thing?
Where the hell is
it? Honeybee.
No, it's not a honeybee. I don't think it's a honeybee.
When I took it out, I mean, the bug was sort of like a mass of just wetness. I don't know if you have like a small dog, but if your small dog gets wet, it kind of looks like a rat, so you have no idea what it really is.
I did not expect that. You know what this probably is? I bet this is a moth.
This looks
like
a moth?
This looks like a moth.
Oh.
Yeah, then that would make more sense, so.
How did a moth come in there?
I did have a patient once that a fly somehow in the hospital flew up her nose. It laid eggs inside of her nose. Come to behold, the next day, maggots were coming out of her nose. That's probably the grossest thing I've ever seen in the nose to date. But that's not gonna happen in the ear. What had happened is that she'd gotten a dental abscess, which is the smelliest kind of sinus infection you can have. And I think that's what attracted the flies.
I can hear.
Yeah, you can hear now. Yeah, he can hear now. He's very happy altogether.
Do you want to keep this for your memoirs?
Yes.
No, don't throw it away.
At the family get together on Sunday.
Oh, everyone's going to hear about this.
All right, sir. This will never happen again, okay?
Hopefully.
Let's hope.
Thank you.
Glad I could help. You guys have a good day.
You do too. Thank you so
much. Yes, we'll see you anytime, all right?
Yep, thanks.
If he didn't come in to see us, that would be there 10 years from now, okay? That thing was not coming out, it was totally stuck. But it's a little terrifying to have a bug in your ear, I think.
My name is Trish. I'm here because I've constantly had sinus infections and I couldn't breathe for a couple of years now.
Morning, Trish. How are you today?
Good today. How you doing?
All right, good.
My infection in my nose came from bad habits, picking in my nose, illegal drugs and stuff. Yeah. So I was doing bad things a long time ago that led me to have to come here and have two surgeries.
Just to kind of recap, when I saw you for the first time, you had had previous sinus surgery and inside of your nose was completely blocked.
Yes.
You had absolutely no ability to breathe. So I've been seeing Trish since about last fall. And as a result of some misspent youth, she had a really bad situation with her nose. She had scarring and there was a very large septal perforation that was crusting and she couldn't breathe through her nose at all. And we did a sinus surgery. She's a lot better, but I don't know if she's ever gonna be able to have a completely normal nose. What we were able to do is kind of reduce the turbinate size, open things up, and I think you did great after that.
Yeah.
And then we had a little bit of two steps backwards with a little bit of an infection. Mm-hmm. Right now, I think what we're dealing with is just a little bit of crusting.
Yes.
We'll kind of just clean things out so you can breathe a little better, okay?
Okay.
I think her prognosis is actually quite good with regard to function, breathing, and her ability to smell and those types of things. But just her way back when remote history of intranasal drug use, it destroyed her nose. And, you know, that's something you end up having to live with forever, unfortunately.
Okay. All right, we're pretty much done. Looking good.
Feel great.
Yeah.
So I'm breathing better now. There's no more crust. The next step is life. I'm gonna live right, keep my nose clean, and do better things. Thank you so much.
Good deal. We'll see you in a few weeks, okay?
Okay, thank you.